Do you know which branch of government declares wars?
Which branch of government declares wars? I do not.
Do you know how long the term of a U.S. senator is?
The term of a U.S. senator, I believe it's 8 years. It could be, I don't know.
Six.
It's six, okay. I knew it was above the four. I didn't
know. Yeah, it's close. It's close.
Only 2 in 5 Americans know that we have 3 branches of government and can name them, the legislative, judicial, and executive branches. Only 1 out of 5 know that we have 100 U.S. senators, even though we've had 100 U.S. senators for more than half a century, ever since Alaska and Hawaii came into the Union. And it's a nice, easy, round number. Easy to remember.
Which branch of the government declares war? Executive branch?
I don't know.
No?
Okay. What branch does?
Oh, it's the Congress.
Oh.
Hasn't happened in many years, though. They kind of gave up that right. Where do you get your news from?
My news from the TV.
From TV?
Yeah.
Do you know who your congressman is?
For this state?
Yeah.
Yes, I do. What's her name? I can't remember. It's a lady.
The lady. You
it's
think
a
of
congresswoman.
The congresswoman. You think of the senator.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know the difference between a senator and a congressman?
Not exactly.
The optimists say, oh, the voters are smart enough. They point to the shortcuts voters use to make up for their lack of information. For instance, a voter who hasn't been following an election very closely may turn to a friend who has and say, hey, who are you going to vote for? Or they may turn to a newspaper whose opinions they trust and look to see who the editors are backing. In addition, they understand failure and success. When times are good, they reward the party that's in power and the candidates of that party. When times are bad, they punish those people who are in power by throwing them out of office. Great, right? Everything's great. Wrong.
I for president, I for president, I for president, I for president. You like Ike, I like Ike, everybody likes Ike.
For president,
hang out the banner, beat the drum, we'll take Ike to Washington. We'll take Ike to Washington.
Now is the time for all good Americans to come to the aid of their country.
The voters made 3 classic errors. Number 1, they came to believe that Saddam Hussein was behind 9/11 even though he wasn't. And why did they believe this? Of course, because of all the dropped hints of the Bush-Cheney officials. But when the 9/11 Commission reported that Saddam had nothing to do with 9/11, the people apparently didn't believe it, or they didn't pay attention, or something, because they continued to insist that he did. This was an important misunderstanding, because a majority of Americans believed that if Saddam didn't have anything to do with 9/11, they would have opposed the invasion of his country. Number 2, let's talk about WMD. The Bush-Cheney administration, of course, left the false impression that Saddam had WMD. Maybe sincerely, maybe not. But here's the point. The voters believed it even after the 9/11 Commission said that there was no proof. Even after Richard Clark, even after the UN, even after David Kay said there was no proof that Saddam had WMD. In fact, we had spent $1 billion trying to find them and we couldn't find them. People didn't care about the facts. Number 3, On the eve of the invasion of Iraq, only one-third of Americans understood that the world opposed the invasion. Another third believed that the rest of the world was neutral, and still another third thought the rest of the world loved the idea of the invasion and supported it. All of this leads me to ask, if the voters cannot get something of the magnitude of 9/11 in Iraq right, in other words, if they can't get the basic facts right about something this important, how can we believe that they can get much of anything right about all the other issues that face them, that aren't on the front pages of the paper every single day?
For whatever reason, I just never really ventured into learning more about politics. Probably as an American, I probably should. But to tell you the truth, I'm being honest, I don't know.
Are the American people stupid? I think that would be as stupid as saying that the people are smart, which politicians love to say all the time, which is really kind of stupid. But I do think we have to have the courage to point out the truth about the people's shortcomings. It's time that we break that taboo. I'm Rick Shenkman, the author of Just How Stupid Are We? Facing the Truth About the American Voter.